Balancing a game is a key element for creating a nice and engaging gameplay experience. In this episode, I will share a useful script that can help other game devs to balance their game faster, saving time and effort. I've used this script to fine-tune my main gameplay loop, so keep watching and I will give you an overview of it. Hi everybody, welcome to this new devlog. I'm Exka and I'm developing a colony simulation game set in space, Too Far Too Late. In the game, you start a new colony with a team of astronauts, making it self-sufficient. You build a base, mine resources, craft items, and grow plants to survive. The game has many engineering challenges, like managing the atmosphere of the base, dealing with limited resources, and overcoming unexpected events. Your colony will explore different landscapes, mine resources, build bases, and expand across the solar system. The game offers layers of realism, with advanced atmospheric, fluid, and energy simulation while providing a challenging survival experience as you manage the needs of your colonists. The first goal of the colonist is to build a small outpost using the components available in the lander. But these components are not enough, so they need to gather more resources by mining ores like iron, copper, gold, and quartz. With these resources, they can craft their own components for construction and expand the outpost. Once the outpost is built, players must ensure its habitability by using canisters of oxygen to pressurize the interior, making the air breathable for the colonists. To sustain themselves, the colonists can grow plants within the outpost, which generate oxygen and provide food. However, if they fail to grow enough food or to produce enough oxygen to survive, the astronaut will suffer the consequences like suffocation and death. The food system is still in development, but it will work similarly to the oxygen and sleep needs, adding an essential aspect to the gameplay loop. If a character's health becomes low, they won't be able to work as effectively for the colony. In some cases, if their health gets too low and they cannot be saved or healed in time, they may die. When his colonist dies, the player will take control of another colonist from the team to continue on its mission. When all the colonists are lost, the games give the player a chance to start again with a new team of colonists by visiting the base many months after the incident. Now that I've explained how the games work, let me talk about an important topic of this devlog, how I'm making sure the game stays enjoyable by balancing the experience. Developing this game is challenging because I want to create a balanced experience that provides a good challenge for the players without being too punishing. Since this game has sandbox elements, players should have the freedom to try different strategies to improve their colony. I must balance the game to ensure that players have what they need without feeling limited just to one path or one only way to build their base and systems. The starting conditions of the game are crucial. Players can't get stuck with too few items or, on the other hand, too many resources that take away the survival challenge and make some other parts of the gameplay useless. To make sure the game is balanced, I used a Google Sheet with initially 3 pages full of formulas and variables to adjust. The first page is for the oxygen balancing, where I aimed to provide enough oxygen for the astronauts and to pressurize a small base for growing plants. The second page focused on energy production and consumption. I ensured that the starting base generates sufficient energy for basic systems and that a battery can store enough power to get through the nights with minimal downtime. The third page listed all the items required to build a starter base, but not too many, so players have to mine and craft some items themselves. In my game, I use Scriptable Objects to store all the items' data and many gameplay settings. These scriptable objects are like files that exist not only when the game is running, but also in the Unity editor. This way, all the balancing can be done right in Unity during gameplay, and the changes are saved even after stopping the game. Balancing the games requires trying out many different combinations of settings to ensure it's challenging and fun to play. I will show how my scripts work and use an example of game that you can download on the YouTuber Zigurous repository, which is a simple Space Invader game. If you're new to game development, I suggest to watch his channel. I've modified the project to set up the main gameplay variables as scriptable objects, so I can modify it to tune the gameplay. Opening each scriptable object one by one can be time consuming, so my script is going to help me with this task. The script can load my settings from my Google Sheet, import a CSV file, find the right scriptable object by its name, and modify specific values in its variables. I will explain each step in detail and share the complete script so that you can use it in your own project. First of all, I need to export my Google Sheet to a CSV file. Google provides a way to open a sheet as a CSV file using a special URL that contains the address of the file and a special command to export it as a CSV file, specifying the ID of the page to be exported. So the first step of my script was to load this remote file and interpret it. Loading a remote file is rather easy. I start by executing a web request with Unity's networking library and wait until the file is loaded, then I take the result test of the loaded file. A CSV file is also easy to parse into values, and reading it character by character was a trick to avoid splitting a line on every comma, as the file can contain text with commas. The main goal of this function is to create a dictionary of values for each line of the CSV. Each line of the CSV is split into an array of values, then I keep the first row or header as the name of my variables. Each other line will be converted into a dictionary in which I can look for a value by the name of its variable. Once the file is transformed, the script is now able to execute different functions. Each row of the file is treated as an instruction to execute, containing a command, a specific parameter like a variable's name, and value. I will detail only the main command, which is also the more complex, to find the specified scriptable object to update its value. To update a value, the script first searches for the specific scriptable object to modify, using its name as a reference. All the scriptable objects are kept referenced in a dictionary, which is automatically updated in the Unity editor. These scriptable objects can be different from each other and have various types of variables. As it will be very tedious to create a separate function for each type of scriptable object, the script uses a technique called reflection to update the variable without depending on the exact object type. This allows the script to handle different types of scriptable objects dynamically, making the updating process more flexible. I just have to identify if my variable is a string, an integer, or a float, then I can try to convert it to the expected type. To simplify the task, I set an f at the final of the value for float, so I can make the difference with integers. Then, I can use reflection to get the target object type, identify its variable, and finally set its value. As it is a scriptable object, I must force the inspector to set it as dirty to be sure that its new value will be serialized and saved after closing the project. Now, in this Space Invader little project, I could change some of the speed settings, projectiles numbers, etc. to make the game easier or harder and balance it even during the gameplay. Returning to my project, the script runs only when the game is loading. After listing all the names of the scriptable object and the variables to adjust, I used formulas to update my main sheet, which generates the CSV file loaded by the script. Now, starting a new game, I can check that the starting conditions have changed and I have a different quantity of object in the initial lander. So, to summarize the script, all the balancing data is centralized on one page in Google Sheet. The script loads this data using the CSV format and then searches for each variable stored in the scriptable objects, updating their values accordingly. I'm sharing a link in the description of this video so you can find the original project, my modifications, the updating script, and the example of a balancing sheet for the Space Invader game. I hope that will be useful for other game devs when thinking about their game structure and balancing. To finish balancing my game, I've made several adjustments related to different gameplays. The energy consumption of devices has been updated, reducing it for some items, so players won't need to build too many solar panels for a small outpost. Additionally, the battery size has been increased, allowing the outpost on Mars to have enough energy to last through the night without interruptions. I have adjusted the oxygen canisters provided in the lander, increasing their pressure to supply the player with a total amount of 10 days of oxygen. After that, players should be able to produce their own oxygen. Lastly, I've increased some items in the initial lander. For example, the quantity of iron beams is now higher so the player can construct enough frames for the outpost structure without having to craft too much. That's all for the balancing of my game, at least for now. I've also worked on updating some older scripts to make the overall gameplay experience more dynamic. One of these improvements is related to the gas simulation speed, which now accelerates the movements of gases in airlocks, pumps, canister fillers, filters, and more, creating a more dynamic experience to the player. Another satisfying improvement is the explosion system, which has been accelerated to create the impression of a chain reaction when many objects are impacted. This makes the explosion more satisfying to watch and horrific to the player. Now that the main gameplay loop is complete and balanced, my next goal is to conduct playtesting to find and fix bugs, optimize the game, and determine my next priorities based on the feedback from the playtesting sessions. If you're interested in taking part in the playtests, you're welcome to join my Discord and get in touch with me. Thanks for watching, don't forget to follow my project, and I see you in the next video. Bye!